Dear students, in this video we will be discussing some important terminologies for belt drives. Okay, actually in our semester examination they may ask you 2 marks from this topic or subdivision for big question. Okay, that's why I have given short notes of these important terminologies of belt drives. First one, the velocity ratio of the flat belt. Okay, this is the same diagram as we have seen for the length of the open belt. This is the driver pulley and this is the driven pulley. This is the belt and this is the open belt drive. And this side is the tight side and this side is the slack side. And it is not necessary to be in the same orientation always. It is actually based upon the rotational sense of rotation of the driver and the driven pulley. For example, here I have to, this driver has to rotate and pull the belt like this, and this is trying to pull the belt so that this side will be felt by tight tension, more tension. So this is tight side. So here you will be getting slack side. Okay, so based on the sense of rotation we have different tight side and a different slack side. So the belt will be substituting by different tensions in the upper side and the lower side. Okay, here if you take the angular velocity of the pulley, driver pulley, that is 2 pi n by 60. Omega 1 is the angular velocity of the driver, so 2 pi n 1 by 60. Omega 2 is the angular velocity of the driven, so 2 pi n 2 by 60. If you want to take the ratio, that is speed ratio or velocity ratio, just take the driver and driven. Okay, this velocity ratio is very important for all power transmitting devices because we need power transmission as well as sometimes speed reductions also. Okay, with this speed I need this power. In the, for this condition we will be changing the speed ratios. So speed ratio is very important for all the power transmitting devices. In the upcoming video we will be discussing about the gear trains where the speed ratio is very, very important. Now speed of the driver to speed of the driven is the omega 1 by omega 2, that is equal to just n1 by n2. So velocity ratio can be calculated by using angular velocity as well as rpm. Now if you take the linear velocity of the belt, see belt is passing like this and moving like this. So linear velocity of the belt is equal to based upon the driver diameter, that is equal, we know the linear velocity is always pi d n. Okay, now based upon the driver diameter, driver pulley, pi d 1 and n 1. The same way based upon the driven, v 2 is equal to pi d 2 n 2. Okay, but for the practical purpose this would be equal, v1 is equal to v2, because belt is passing over this pulley and then moving over here. Okay, for no slip condition this should be equal. No slip means there is no slip between belt and the pulley. Pulley is continuously rotating, there is no relative motion between pulley and the belt. Okay, in that condition v1 should be equal to v2. Whatever the velocity of belt in this direction will be same as in this direction. So v1 is equal to v2, so that if you write this, d1 by d2 is equal to n2 by n1. If you equate this, you will be getting this formula, which means bigger the diameter, lower the speed. Because lower the diameter, higher the speed. Speed and diameter is always inversely proportional to each other. This is for no slip condition. But there is a slip. Okay, when belt is moving here, there is no slip, but when belt moves over the pulley, there is a relative motion between pulley and the belt. Due to that relative motion, the belt may slip off from the driver. So based upon the slip percentage, there will be occurring of slippage. So here if you consider the effect of slip, the velocity will be changing. So always the slip is given in terms of percentage. For example, slip between belt and driver is S1%, slip between belt and driven is S2%. Here S1%, here S2%. Now the linear velocity can be written as V1 minus. Why V1 minus? Here V1 is the velocity of belt moving over here, but when it moves over the driver pulley, it will felt some relative motion, so there is a slip. So V1 minus this much velocity is not gained by the, is will be lost by, this much velocity is lost by the belt when moves over the pulley, driver pulley. So V1 minus how much percentage? S1 percentage. So S1 by 100 into V1. This is the actual velocity moving over the pulley. So V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. The same way, linear velocity between belt and the driven pulley. If you take driven pulley, previously it was V2, but now V2 can be written as V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. This velocity, actually, if there is no slip, this velocity will be felt by the belt in this direction also. But now there is a slip over the driven diameter, driven pulley. So we have to consider that slip rate. So from this velocity, you have to subtract this much percentage. What is the percentage? S2. S2 percentage of what? What is the velocity available in the previous state? So previous state is V1 into 1 minus S1 by 100. So take the common value V1, you will be getting 1 minus S1 by 100 minus into 1 minus S2 by 100 into, this is equal to V1 into, just multiply this term, you will be getting this, in this S1 into S2 by 10,000. This is very very low value, so you can easily neglect this. And remaining V2 is equal to V1 into 1 minus S1 plus S2 by 100. And what is S1 plus S2? That is the total slip. Here for this system, the slip is in driver S1, slip in driven is S2. So total slip will be S1 plus S2. So if you take total slip as S, the velocity passing over the driven pulley, within the velocity of the belt passing over the driven pulley, is equal to V1 into 1 minus S by 100. If no slip condition, there is no slip, you will be getting V2 is equal to V1. But when there is a slip, you will be getting V2 is equal to V1 into 1 minus S by 100. So for the 2 mark, they may ask you what is the definition of slip. Okay, let me read the definition for the slip. It is a phenomenon of relative motion between belt and pulley. It is a phenomenon of relative motion between belt and pulley due to insufficient of grip of friction. Okay, how we felt the slip? When there is lesser amount of friction between belt and the pulley, that time the belt will may slip off from the pulley. So due to insufficient grip of friction between belt and pulley, there are some relative motion. That slip is known as relative motion. The belt will move off from the pulley, so relative motion in between those two is present. This motion is called slip of the belt. This motion is known as slip of the belt. They may ask you the definition of slip in 2 mark. Okay, next important terminology for the belt drives is ratio of belt tensions. Ratio of belt tensions. Here I will be discussing the formulas only, as all other concepts are beyond the syllabus, and that will be for all other concepts making you understanding the concepts very difficult. Okay, so I won't teach those concepts in this topic. So what are the topics available in the syllabus, I will be teaching in this video. Now, ratio of belt tensions. We have two tensions. One is tension in the tight side, tension in the slack side. If you take the ratio, you will be getting e power mu into theta, where T1 is the tension in the tight side, T2 is the tension in the slack side. And mu is the coefficient of friction between belt and pulley. And theta is the angle of wrap. Okay, in the previous diagram, you might have seen the angle of wrap. Okay, the angle at which belt passes over the pulley, that is the angle of wrap. Okay, now they may ask you in 2 mark about this ratio of belt and tension with some numerical. Okay, they may give you all the values directly, you just substitute in this formula. Next, power transmission in the belt. Power transmission is generally force into velocity. Here force is difference of two tensions, because we have different tensions in the same belt. So T1 minus T2 into velocity. v is the velocity of the belt. V is the linear velocity of the belt, not angular velocity. V is the linear velocity of the belt. Here condition for maximum, there is a condition for maximum power transmission, because power is a function of velocity. So for maximum power, the velocity should be equal to root under root of T by 3 into M, where T is the maximum tension in the belt. Obviously, the maximum tension will be tight side tension. So maximum tension divided by 3 times mass of the belt. M is the mass of the belt. Next important phenomenon is creep. As we have already discussed, the relative motion between belt and pulley, because of the insufficient frictional grip, there is another relative motion between belt and pulley because of the unequal stretching of the belt. Unequal stretching of the belt. As I already told you, in belt drives arrangement, the belt is substituted. The belt is substituted under higher tension in the tight side, under lower tension in the slack side. So it may be getting different stretches when moving, when passes over the pulleys. So creep is the relative motion, this is also kind of relative motion between belt and pulley surface due to unequal stretching of the two sides of the drive. Unequal stretching of the two sides of the drive. The tensions are different in tight side as well as slack side. So it felt different stretches, and especially unequal stretching, so that there is a relative motion between belt and pulley. The effect of creep slow down the speed of the belt. The effect of creep slow down the speed of the belt on the driven pulley. The same way, slippage is also reducing the velocity of the belt, or speed of the belt over the pulley. Okay, thank you.